Today we're installing wave attenuation devices, or WADs, along the causeway of the Max Brewer Bridge in Titusville.
Prevailing winds cause erosion, and wave attenuation devices decrease wave energy. These WADs in particular decrease wave energy up to 92%. You'll see them in high energy situations with 2-3 foot waves crashing into them, and right behind them, it'll be calm. It's really important for the lagoon. It protects from coastal erosion, and it protects from critical habitat getting washed away during storms and high wind events. The WAD is a three-sided concrete pyramid with holes in them, and they're set up in a row. And each row has two WADs that kind of fit together. Wave energy will hit the base of the WAD and then get dissipated through the holes. When it goes around the sides, it hits another WAD, and that's why they're offset. And the unique thing about the WAD is that some wave energy does push through. In a lot of our projects, it's coastline building, where we've lost a lot of coastline. These will actually allow sediment to be transferred through them, and that's kind of what we're looking for. So this project is one of the first multi-trophic projects in the state of Florida, and definitely the largest, so that it encompasses different environments and habitat restorations. The WADs protect the shoreline, and then behind the WADs, we'll be able to replant seagrass, and the Indian River Lagoon has lost a large percentage of the seagrass. We're gonna plant about 5 acres of seagrass behind the WADs. We're then gonna drone drop about 1 million clams into the grass, and they have kind of a symbiotic relationship and help each other thrive.
In addition to the WADs, we're going to stabilize the shoreline by doing plantings from the top of the shoreline all the way into the water. There's over 10,000 plantings over 1,900 linear feet of shoreline. Protection of the causeway enhances the ecotourism of the surrounding community. It also provides fish habitat, and it restores the shoreline.
One of the reasons we selected this site is it's an important nursery ground for horseshoe crabs, and at one point they counted over 55,000 horseshoe crabs spawning along the shore.
This project is very different because it has many stakeholders. It's coming from the Save Our Indian River Lagoon, which is covering the plantings in the shoreline, a portion of them. There's also the Department of Environmental Protection Resiliency Program, the St. John's Water Management District, Florida Inland Navigation District, FPNL, Tourism Development Council, and the Florida Wildlife Commission.
So this project incorporates a lot of different elements to help benefit the Indian River Lagoon. And you can actually do the same thing around your home by planting native plants in your landscaping, which reduces the need for fertilizer and for excess irrigation. And combining that with things like blowing your grass clippings back into your lawn so they don't wash into the storm drains and become muck, you can do several different activities to help benefit the lagoon. Find out how you can join us in getting to a healthier lagoon faster by learning tips and tricks at lagoonloyal.com.